from Canadian. Keeping the Commonwealth rolling. Michael Barber, please come up to the microphone.
Thank you. It's interesting to go after Flanders Field, given that it was written by a Canadian, John McCrae, the young Army doctor. Good morning, everyone. I would like to bring greetings from the Royal Canadian Legion, U.S. Branch 25, which represents the San Francisco Bay Area. Now, I'm sure some of you may be wondering why there's a Canadian that's involved with the Anzac Day ceremony here today. While Australia and New Zealand were able to fight at Gallipoli as distinct national units, there were approximately 1,000 officers and young men from what was then the tiny island colony of Newfoundland. They would be sent to Suvla Bay to join the 88th Brigade of the 29th Division of the British Army. Now, the Newfoundland Regiment, or the Blue Puttees as they were known, because Newfoundland being a poor colony at the time, they weren't able to issue khaki puttees to them, arrived at Gallipoli on the 25th of April, 1915. Like many of those who were already there, the Newfoundlanders were initially bogged down in the trench warfare for many months, and it wasn't until November 4th that the unit would distinguish itself with the capture of a ridge that became known as Caribou Hill, the caribou being the symbol for the Newfoundland Regiment throughout the war. By the end of the campaign, the Newfoundlanders had distinguished themselves so much that they were trusted to maintain the rear of the retreating Anzac forces and British forces as they were leaving the Gallipoli Peninsula. The Newfoundland Regiment only suffered minor losses compared to the other Allied forces during Gallipoli, losing only 40 men. Beaumont Hamel, which was part of the Battle of the Somme in July 1916, would be the day of reckoning for the Newfoundlanders. Of the 780 soldiers who went over the top on the 1st of July, only 68 were able to answer the roll call the following morning. It's interesting to note that the Newfoundland Regiment were actually the only regiment granted the Royal designation during the First World War. And also kind of ironic that the Newfoundlanders were actually not supposed to join the Gallipoli campaign, but were called into service when the Royal Scottish Regiment suffered a fatal train crash between Edinburgh and London on their way to Gallipoli. The Newfoundlanders, who would not become part of Canada until 1949, were the only North American troops at Gallipoli, fighting alongside their Australian, New Zealand, and British comrades. As a native Newfoundlander myself, it is with great pride that I represent the Royal Canadian Legion here today.
Thank you, Michael. Very good insight. And a great connection to the Canadians, especially. You hear about these circumstances of war, and we deal with circumstances on a daily basis, and hearing about the Scottish having a train accident on the way down to Gallipoli is a weird circumstance. But we're going to move on now with the wreath presentation, or the laying of the wreaths.